we join in singing the entrance hymn, Lead Your Children. Lead your children, Jesus, to the altar. Lead your children, Jesus, here we come. Our hearts are filled with love, our lips are filled with song. Lead your children, Jesus, here we come. Lead your children, Jesus, to the altar. Lead your children, Jesus, here we come. We know you love us all, we know you call us friends. Lead your children, Jesus, here we come. Thanksgiving masses offered by Nicole Shaji on her 20th birthday. Two parishioners for favors received. A parishioner for recovery from COVID-19 and Bernardine Fernandez. For the intentions of Avril Barton on her birthday, Joseph and Lasbinda Tavares, Cynthia D'Souza for a speedy recovery, Edward Vegas for recovery from COVID, and Bobby and Marianne Meneses for good health. For the souls of Joe Fernandez, Luis and Francina Gonzalez, Sister Andrew, Janet Solomon and departed members of family, Joachim D'Souza, Leo and Alice D'Souza, Vincent and Mariangel DeMello, Stella Nerona, Maxwell Thompson Ribello, Lily D'Souza, Joseph Marianne Pinto, Irene Conception Lewis, Wilma Nunes, and for the souls in purgatory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brethren, today we celebrate the martyrdom of Saint Maximilian Kolbe, who died saving the other. As we look at his life story in the homily, we will realize how he bore witness to Christ, his master. Each of us as Christians are invited to do the same, to bear witness to Christ and his values. For the times that we have failed to do our work faithfully, let's ask his pardon and forgiveness and prepare ourselves worthily to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who filled the priest and martyr, Saint Maximilian Kolbe, with a burning love for the Immaculate Virgin Mary, and with zeal for souls and love of neighbor, graciously grant through his intercession that striving for your glory by eagerly serving others, we may be conformed even until death to your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Joshua. In those days, Joshua spoke to the people, saying, "Now fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Put away the gods that your fathers served beyond the river and in Egypt, and serve the Lord. And if it is evil in your eyes to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your fathers served in the region beyond the river or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Then the people answered, far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods, for it is the Lord our God who brought us and our fathers up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, and who did those great signs in our sight and preserved us in all the way that we went and among all the peoples through whom we passed. And the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who lived in the land. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God. But Joshua said to the people, you are not able to serve the Lord, for he is a holy God. He is a jealous God. He will not forgive your transgressions or your sins. If you forsake the Lord and serve foreign gods, then he will turn and do you harm and consume you after having done you good. And the people said to Joshua, no, but we will serve the Lord. Then Joshua said to the people, you are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen the Lord to serve him. And they said, we are witnesses. He said, put away the foreign gods that are among you and incline your heart to the Lord, the God of Israel. And the people said to Joshua, the Lord our God we will serve, and his voice we will obey. So Joshua made a covenant with the people that day and put in place statutes and rules for them at Shechem. And Joshua wrote these words in the book of the law of God. And he took a large stone and set it up there under the terebinth that was by the sanctuary of the Lord. And Joshua said to all the people, behold, this stone shall be a witness against us, for it has heard all the words of the Lord that he has spoken to us. Therefore, it shall be a witness against you, lest you deal falsely with your God. So Joshua sent the people away, every man to his inheritance. After these things, Joshua, the son of Nun, the servant of the Lord, died, being 110 years old. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to the psalm will be, it is you, O Lord, who are my portion.
It is you, O Lord, who are my portion.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, you are my Lord. O Lord, it is you who are my portion and my cup, for you yourself who secure my lot.
It is you, O Lord, who are my portion.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord before me always. With him at my right hand, I shall not be moved.
It is you, O Lord, who are my portion.
You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence. At your right hand, bliss forever.
It is you, O Lord, who are my portion. We prepare our hearts to listen to the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have revealed to little children the mysteries of the kingdom.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, children were brought to Jesus, that he might lay his hands on them and pray. The disciples rebuked the people, but Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of heaven." And he laid his hands on them and went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, as we heard at the beginning of the Mass, in the introduction, today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Maximilian Kolbe. He became a martyr as he took the place of a prisoner in a Nazi concentration camp. His life of sacrifice inspires each of the Christians to follow Christ more closely. Maximilian Kolbe was born in Poland, which was the part of Great Russian Empire, in the year 1894. From his younger age, he was very much devoted to Mother Mary. And because of his devotion, he says that it is through the vision that he received from Mother Mary, he became a priest and later was able to go out and proclaim the good news. The vision he narrates like this. He says, "I was sleeping one night after asking Mother Mary what I was to do with my life. And in the vision, Mother Mary came to me with two crowns. One was white, the other was red. And she told me, one, the white one symbolized perseverance in purity, and the red one symbolized martyrdom. She asked me which of the one I would choose out of these two. And I took the both of those, white and the red. And from that day on, his life changed. After that year, within a year, he joined the Franciscans, the conventuals, where his other brother had joined. Later, he was ordained a priest, and he wanted to work against the religious indifference that was very prevalent during those times. He even worked in the east part of the Asia and established a Catholic church in Japan. After working extensively for many years as a missionary abroad, he was called back to Poland. And then he was put in charge of the mission there. It was the time of the World War which was going on, and during that time, Nazis, who wanted to eliminate all the leaders who were provoking the people against them, arrested Father Maximilian Kolbe along with the other four priests. He was put in a concentration camp, and there he started catechizing other prisoners, helping them, listening to their confessions, and instructing them in the way of the Lord. Later, one day, as one of the prisoners escaped from the concentration camp, the Nazi commander, who was very angry, wanted to teach a lesson to others and to put the fear into the minds of the other prisoners. Therefore, he randomly picked 10 prisoners to be starved to death. And when they were marched to the cell, one of those 10 cried out saying, "My wife, my children." Hearing this, Maximilian Kolbe willingly took his place and said, "I would die in that man's place because he has a family." As they were led into the solitary cell to die, Maximilian Kolbe encouraged the others to pray, to confess their sins, and to thank God for all the graces, and to ask for the strength that they needed. And therefore, there were no sound of lamentations from those cells, as usually it would happen. All of them died, only Maximilian Kolbe remained till the end. But the soldiers who wanted the cell to be empty injected for the Maximilian with carbolic acid, because of which he died. One of the lines from today's gospel plays a very important role in the life of a disciple. That which says, the children were brought to Jesus. The mission of every disciple or apostle or the follower of Christ is to bring people to Jesus. And that is what Maximilian Kolbe did through his life. By preaching, also through the example of his own life, he brought others to Jesus. Many were converted listening to this life-giving sacrifice that he had committed for the fellow prisoner whom he did not know. Today we need to ask ourselves, as disciples of Christ, how willing are we to bring others to Jesus? If we have really experienced Jesus and his love in our lives, we will be ever willing to bring others to him. And once we bring them to Jesus, Jesus blesses them. Only thing that we need to have as we come to Jesus is childlike simplicity, innocence, and openness to accept his blessings. Today we need to ask ourselves two important questions. Are we still with Jesus? Are we childlike as we come to Jesus? Are we open to receive his graces? And the second one, are we willing to bring others to Jesus so that they may be blessed as well? During this Eucharistic celebration, through the intercession of St. Maximilian Kolbe, we pray that we may be instruments of bringing God's mercy, love, and salvation to others. Amen.
What can I give? What can I bring that would be pleasing to my King? I'll give my heart, not just a part. I'm lifting up my everything. Well, it's all I have to offer, and it's all I have to give. Two hands, one heart, one life to offer you. Two hands, one heart, that's what I give to you.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
We present our oblations to you, O Lord, humbly praying that we may learn from the example of Saint Maximilian to offer our very lives to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the one who comes from God on high. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, to set your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual Communion Prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that renewed by the body and blood of your Son, we may be inflamed with the same fire of charity that Saint Maximilian received from this holy banquet, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer in times of coronavirus. Mother of perpetual help, with the greatest confidence we come before your picture to beseech your intercession. We think of you, Mother, at the foot of the cross. Your heart must have bled to see your Son in agony, but your joy was great when he rose from the dead, victorious over the powers of evil. Mother of sorrows, pray for us in this time of trial. Help us not to lose heart. Intercede for your people who are afflicted with coronavirus. Comfort your people who are vulnerable and anxious. Protect healthcare workers who put their lives at risk. Inspire our leaders to make good decisions. Change our hearts so that we may act responsibly. Teach us to trust in God's love and mercy, and to share with you the joy of having courageously faced up to all the challenges of life. Amen. Mother of perpetual help,
pray for us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. We join in the final hymn, Listen to Your People. Listen to your people, linked now hand in hand. Gathered at your table, secure in love we stand. As seekers of your kingdom, we unite to pray. Jesus, Savior, guide us, for you are the way.